Hello there.
How's?
Excuse me. How is everybody doing? This is T-Mott, of course. You've seen me before. I want to do this little drive time, but I pulled over to do this one, and so I just want to kind of walk you people through some things. We've got 15 days until election time. I shall repeat something that Louis Farrakhan said. When you vote, vote for knowledge. Vote with knowledge. Likewise, I say to you, get an understanding. I've told many people before that have commented out of ignorance, and I don't mean that in a negative way. I mean that in terms of you're commenting about something that you lack understanding on, and if you would take time to do some research for yourself, learn about the people that you are going to vote for, learn about the process, you could make a more intelligent decision, and instead of having to depend on the media, which Donald Trump has proven without a doubt that it is unreliable, that they lie. And I have been telling you that for years, because I experienced the same thing. One of the things that the media said when I ran was, I'm trying to raise money for my campaign off of Johnny Isaacson's illness. So now that I've gotten that out of the way, and the reason I took time to do that, those that are going to listen, I wanted to get them a chance to get on here. So let's talk about Donald Trump's civil war. See, many of us think that this election is solely about us individually, but it is not about us individually. There are other factions above us that are fighting. Now, we have been griping for a number of years. A revolution started amongst the people going back with Ron Paul. I think it actually began with Ross Perot, because Ross Perot was talking about the things that were taking place in this country that was killing this country, including trade deals. And he spoke out against NAFTA. He saw the beginning of the end for Americans, because he said people that can't make anything can't buy anything. So this goes back a while, but little has happened in Washington, D.C. in the way of making things better for the people. We have not seen that. And the only person, save myself, because I surely told you that if you send me to D.C., I'm going to name names. I'm going with a broom, a flashlight, and a whistle. Well, on a national level, the only person that we have seen doing that, save Ron Paul and Rand Paul, except, you know, they don't name names like Trump has been doing, nor have they exposed the press as Trump has been doing. That person is Trump. So let me show you how his election is much like the Civil War that started back in the 1860s. So we had the North and we had the South. We had the industrialists in the North. They had factories, et cetera, et cetera. They had employees that they had to pay. Now, in the South, we had the slave owners. Now, the slave owners, they did the tobacco, the cotton, and other items that required laborers as well, just like the folk up in the North, except the South got their labor for free, essentially. The only thing they had to do was feed the slaves, buy new slaves. If one got sick, ran away, or they hung it because it, you know, just the slave just didn't want to play the game anymore, whatever the case may be, they'd have to go down to the auction block and buy a new slave. So now we got the people in the South making their loot. We got the people in the North making their loot. Now, the rich white folk in the North was upset with the rich white folks in the South. The industrialists was pissed with the slave owners of the South. Why? Because they thought that they had an unfair advantage when it came to policies, tariffs, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And on top of that, the United States at the time was getting ready to expand westward. Well, the rich white folk in the North didn't want the rich white folks in the South to expand westward while having the advantage of slaves. You know, they already had that little thing about the three-fifths issue. That was sort of like a compromise because the folk in the South wanted to be able to count even their slaves when it came down to getting legislation passed. So during this time, there were basically two special interest groups, the industrialists and the slave owners. That's right. The two industrialists that wanted the politicians to do what they wanted them to do. Now, there was a third group, but they were not, I wouldn't call them a special interest group. I'd call them a morals interest group. They were the abolitionists. So the industrialists saw an opportunity to team up with the abolitionists. Why? Because the abolitionists wanted to outlaw slavery in the United States. Now, the South didn't want to do that. So they got together and they started putting pressure on Lincoln and Congress to do something about this unfair advantage from the industrialist point of view that the South had, and to prevent them from expanding westward with that unfair advantage. And of course, the abolitionists just wanted slavery gone altogether. So Lincoln initially was saying, look, keep your slaves, but you can't expand it westward. And the South said, well, we're going to keep our slaves and we're going to expand westward. And Lincoln was like, no, you know, we can't do that. And that was because of the pressure of the industrialists and the abolitionists. So the South, fearing that not only would they not be able to expand westward, they would also lose their ability to own slaves. So they decided they would secede. With that, brought about the Civil War. So basically, folks, the Civil War was about one group of white folks fighting against another group of white folks, all about economics. So have you followed what I have said so far? So now, let's fast forward to today. Donald Trump and his Civil War. Donald Trump is a self-made billionaire. He took $15 million, approximately, I think the number may be 14, turned it into a minimum of $1 billion. Now, $1 million is if you take $100 million to have a billion, that's $100 million times 10. So you can imagine the amount of work that Donald Trump put into being a self-made billionaire. You understand what I'm saying? Now, most folks say, well, his dad gave him $15 million. You know what? You know what I mean? Most of the people that win the lotto are broke within 5 to 10 years. And that's after winning millions of dollars themselves. They are broke within a few years. Donald Trump didn't go broke within a few years. Donald Trump turned it into $1 billion+. All right, now that I've gotten that out of the way, well, what's the problem? Why did Donald Trump decide to start this civil war? Donald Trump said in the very first debate, I have to pay people on both sides for my business, my family, and my employees. Donald Trump realized, I can't keep paying these bastards off forever just so I can operate at a profit. I'm having to export just to be competitive with other people. This is not the dream that I had. And Donald Trump runs a service industry. You can't offshore hotel service, you know, people at the concierge, people in the bar, people in the lounge. You know, you gotta have people over here working, and it's getting harder and harder to compete. And Donald Trump realized, I have been made a slave too, just like everybody else was back in 1913 with the 16th Amendment, the Central Bank, the Federal Reserve Act, okay, the IRS, the income tax, all those things, they're tapping Donald Trump too. So Donald Trump decided, I am the only person in a position to really do something about it. I want to stop paying these bastards off on the left and the right. I want to expose the media for the lack of sign crap that they are being a part of, or let's just say the fourth branch of government, an arm of Congress and the White House. And I want to name the names of these crooked politicians that are in office. I am in a unique position to do something about that. Now, what is the biggest rub for the political elite? Because that's who the Civil War is between. Donald Trump and the political elite. Why is there a war between them? Because the political elite, unlike Donald Trump, they personally enrich themselves off of the backs of their slaves, the American taxpayer. That's right. That's right. That's right. So the more that they can tax and spend us, the more that they can manipulate and maneuver policies that benefit the folk that are rewarded off of the backs of the American taxpayer. And those are the ones that are the benefactors and beneficiaries of the central bank. Do you see how it's? I did a diagram called the circle of loop, how everything starts with the 1%, goes down through the corporations, the PACs and the super PACs, and then they buy the politicians on both sides. And no matter which politician loses, they still win. And no matter which politician wins, we still lose. You remember me talking about that? Well, that's what we have here. And Donald Trump has been shining a light on it. And the reason the political elite don't like Donald Trump, if Donald Trump is able to stop the 1%, the central bank, the Federal Reserve, whatever name you want to put on it, the corrupt policies that come out of Washington, D.C., if he is able to drain the swamp, the political elite will no longer have a mechanism for personally enriching themselves by being sold like whores, selling themselves like whores to the 1%, the central bank, the Federal Reserve, whatever term you want to use to identify them. And that's what this is all about. Again, so here we are, a civil war between one rich guy and the political elite. Other people that have gotten rich off of the backs of the taxpayers, Hillary Clinton, Bill Clinton, and the list goes on and on and on. Johnny Isaacson, that's right. All of those folks, all of them that have gotten rich because of policies of the government, passing policies from the government that benefit these corporations, the ones that are paying the money to the PACs and super PACs to get the politicians elected that they want. See, I keep saying it over and over because I'm trying to make it make sense to you. They are personally enriching themselves and becoming very wealthy, not building up their wealth like Donald Trump did the old-fashioned way, earning it for himself. Donald Trump is self-made. These people doing it by laying on their backs like a whore and passing the politicians that their benefactors would like for them to pass, that ultimately screw us over. And I said, Months and months ago, that when they win, we lose all the time, no matter who is in office, and that there is only one party. And Donald Trump has made that clear. And again, the political elite, whether Republican or Democrat, get personally enriched, or they personally enrich themselves because they pass policies that hurt the country. The whole goal is to decimate the middle class so that we no longer have a voice. And if Hillary Clinton gets into office, that voice will be wiped out forever. And there will be no more change by ballot. It will come down to bullets. You can take that to the bank. So that is the civil war that Donald Trump is fighting. A civil war. One white man against another group of white folks, the political elites. Now, there are some black people that are in that category as well. That's why nothing ever changes in the black communities. Those black people get up there and blame the white man, tell you to elect them and that they're going to change some things, and they get up there in office, John Lewis, and nothing ever happens. Nothing ever changes, ever. The only person that I know of in this area of town or in Atlanta, the Atlanta area, was Cynthia McKinney, who tried to expose the corruption of the politicians, and they tried to make it seem like she was crazy and out of her mind. But of course, we know that is not true. So, folk, take it for what it's worth. This civil war, the only reason we have a dog in this fight is because Donald Trump is trying to make us to not be the dog in their fight anymore. And the only way for you to stand up and not be the dog anymore is to not vote for Hillary Clinton. Because if you vote for Hillary Clinton, we will continue to be the dogs in the fight. Now, Donald Trump has a dog in the fight. That is all that he has worked for and built for, as he said, my family, my business, and my employees. That's what he's fighting for, so that he don't have to keep playing those bastards off in the Democratic Party or the Republican Party. And that's what it comes down to. This is a civil war that we can fight and win by ballot. And I hope it don't come down to bullets. T-Mod out. Drive time till next time.